Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 7.2, Problem 3. This is Section 7.2, Problem Number 3. It says, look up the value for z in the chart and draw the graph and shade in the appropriate region. And the value we have to look up in the chart is 0.17. So it's a four-step process to look it up. Step one is write the number so that it has two places after the decimal. And you either fill in zeros or round it off as necessary. This number already has two places after the decimal, so step one is all set. Step two, split the number into two parts by pulling off the rightmost digit, which is the 7. So we'll have 0.1, and the 7 comes off to the side. So we split it into two parts by pulling off the rightmost digit. Step three, put a 0.0 in front of the rightmost digit that you've pulled off, so that 7 becomes a 0.07. Step four, go to the chart, and the digit from the left here, the 0.1, will tell you what row of the chart to look in, and the digit from the right with the 0.0 in front of it will tell you what column of the chart to look in. Now, again, the chart is on two pages. There's a positive page and a negative page. Pay attention, this is a positive 0.17. So the 0.1 row is way up near the top. It's only the second row down. And you'll follow that out until you're under the 0.07 column, and you'll see where those intersect. And they intersect the value 0.5675. Now again, what does that mean, 5675? What have we found? What does the answer mean? So what we have here is an area of the bell curve. So you draw the bell curve. Under the center, you put a 0. On the far right, you put a 3. On the left, a negative 3. And what these numbers indicate is how many standard deviations away from the average value you are. 0 in the center means you're 0 standard deviations away from the average value. The center is the average. 3, meaning 3 standard deviations above average. Minus 3 is 3 standard deviations less than the average value. And again, the normal curve, the bell curve, continues forever in both directions, and it gets closer and closer and closer to the line, never quite gets there. You stop drawing when you get 3 standard deviations away from the average on either side. But in reality, it does continue forever. And then by eye, you can evenly space out 1, 2, 3 on the right, and negative 1, negative 2, negative 3 on the left. Now 0.17, it's positive, but it's really close to the 0. So again, if this is a dollar, 0.17 is 17 cents. So it's only a tiny bit bigger than average. That's what we looked up, 0.17, positive. Now the number we got out of the chart is the probability of being less than or to the left of the 0.17. So I'll shade in the area of the chart to the left, and I'll label it 0.5675. So if you like percents for your probability, it's a 56¾% probability of being in the shaded region that's shaded on our bell curve.